You're a good man, Jim Raynor.
I like to dissect girls. Did you know I'm utterly insane?
James, Orlan decrypted your adjutant, but he's planning to sell it to the Dominion. Must have been something exciting in there.
You're a fucking ugly bitch. I want to stab you to death and then play around with your blood.
Well, well, the infamous Jim Raynor.
Not quite blonde, are you? More dirty blonde.
My name is Nova.
Christy. You'll respond only to Christy.
I'm on the verge of tears by the time we arrive at a spot, since I'm positive we won't have a decent table.
That's your face! You think that's a fucking face? You think that's a jack?
There is a moment of sheer panic when I realize that Paul's apartment overlooks the park and is obviously more expensive than mine.
Jesus, Raynor.
You know how bad you smell? You reek of shit! Do you know that?
I have beheld only oblivion.
You got a negative attitude. That's what's stopping you. You gotta get your act together. I'll help you.
And though justice demands that she die, only she...
Listen, you'll have to excuse me. I have a lunch meeting with Cliff Huxtable at Four Seasons in 20...
Time is short. You must understand.
Look at that subtle off-white coloring. A tasteful thickness of it. Oh my god. It even has a watermark.
Did you know that Whitney Houston's debut LP, called simply Whitney Houston, had 4 number one singles on it? It's hard to choose a favorite among so many great tracks. But the greatest love of all is one of the best, most powerful songs ever written. About self-preservation, dignity. This universal message crosses all boundaries and instills one with the hope that it's not too late to better ourselves. Since, Elizabeth, it's impossible in this world we live in to empathize with others. We can always empathize with ourselves. It's an important message. Crucial, really. And it's beautifully stated on the album.
Now that's the commander I've been waiting on.
I made a deal with the devil, Jimmy.
You're a tumbling, tumbling dickweed.
I want you to clean your vagina.